putting hogs on the mind, planting purple seeds. Baltimore Ravens coat, purple trim, big body, old school for low. Purple rim, 7'7" cutty, black with the purple strip.
Good Ravens fam. So, this just a video. We're going to talk about Eric DaCosta, Ozzy. I know there are some new Ravens fans since Lamar. And so they wasn't there with the struggle with Ozzy and everything. So I'm just going to give a few. Ozzy's record is so long about the free agency talk I'm going to speak about. I just want to hear y'all's opinion. And, you know, just kind of do something new. Okay, so at first, I was team Eric DaCosta. I'm like, okay, his first draft, Hollywood, in my opinion, he broke the wide receiver problem the Ravens was having for as drafting a wide receiver. Now, Ozzy's record at drafting a wide receiver in the first round is about like 0-30. That's not the exact number, but you know what I'm saying. It's like that. It's that bad. You know what I'm saying? It's like Sacramento Kings basketball bad, like bad. So I believe he broke that, and I'm like, okay, it's gonna get better and better and better. Then he drafted. I might not be in the right order. Let me see. It was after Hollywood. Okay, he went defense the next year, and I believe that was PQ. Then right after that, he went Rashad Bateman, I believe. Then right after that, I believe it's Cal Hamilton. Okay, if I'm correct. So let me see. Hollywood, PQ. My apology. Okay, we got Hollywood, PQ, Rashad, Owe, this year, Lindenbaum. Cal Hamilton and Lindenbaum. I think that's the right order. That's for the first. Now, I don't know what to go for as the jury on his draft right now. I heard some people say they have given up on him. I heard some people saying he's mid. And I know some people are like, man, Ozzy would never make them picks. And I'm like, I like Ozzy. You know, he's hit on some picks. But look how long of a stand he's had. He has had from 96 to 2018, I believe. Yeah, 2018, because I was at that draft when they drafted Lamar. Now, mentioning Lamar, must we not forget who did he pick before Lamar? The same guy that is not on the team anymore. Hayden Hurst, he picked the tight end over Lamar Jackson. Like, he picked a tight end. Knowing Flacco is, since 2012, I don't even believe we even touched the playoffs for a good amount of time. After that. After Ray Lewis left, after Ed Reed, after Terrell Suggs left. But that's, you know, that's on Harps as well. But mainly on Harps. But he picked Hayden Hurst knowing Flacco's gotta go. Like, it wasn't there anymore. In that draft, I remember I met what's that dude? He worked for the Ravens. I can't even think of his name, y'all. Hold on, let me look it up. I think it is. Is it Gary? Is it Gary? I think I just saw him on Twitter. Is it Gary? Nah, it ain't Gary. It's one of the dudes that does the Gary Downing. Yeah, there we go. Yeah. I met him, and I remember when I was at the draft, I met him because I was like, me and my cousin, we was there, like, I think 8, 9 a.m. We was ready. We was hyped. He had his Frisco girl, and I had my Ravens girl. I had my Jimmy Smith I was representing. But I met him, and he was like, man, who do you think the Ravens are going to get? I said, they got to get Lamar Jackson. Flacco's got to go. He started laughing and everything. He's like, well, it's going to be interesting. We're going to see. And I remember I was like, okay, it's time. Lamar's still there. My cousin, his team already picked. He had Lamar's Instagram up when Lamar was sitting there showing, you know, him sitting at the table until they told him to cut it off. But I was like, bro, he's on the phone. He's not on the phone. We coming up, this type of stuff. Then they say Hayden Hurst. And I said, Ozzie Newsome picked Hayden Hurst over a generational talent like Lamar. You picked a tight end. Still don't understand it to this day. But let us not forget that. Ozzie has had Matt Elam. He's had Cyrian Graven. He had Bashard Perriman. He's had so many. Like, dude, Mark Clayton. I'm sorry. I know some people like Mark Clayton. He was decent, but not first round. Yeah, so he's had, like, a load of, you know, bad picks. And while all during that time, who was under him? Eric DaCosta. Now, Eric DaCosta does have his own right to pick his own players, but in my opinion, I believe one of the problems is that he's, because I remember seeing the story about Eric DaCosta wanting to draft Derwin James. Okay, Derwin James. He wanted to get Derwin James, and he wanted to trade up and get him. And I can't find the exact story, but I remember it. I was like, Ozzie, why? He wanted to trade up and get him. He wanted to give away some kids, and Ozzie was like, no. You know how we do. We sit there and wait and let it come to, let the picks come to us. And I still believe he goes by that philosophy of letting the picks come to us. Sometimes when you have a generational talent, you just got to go up there and say, screw these picks and get them. And that's not the Ravens' way. And I was hoping when Eric DaCosta took over, he was going to do that type of stuff. But it brings to differ, do he have that power to do that? Ozzie's still in the building. Harbaugh is Harbaugh. And you know what I mean when I say that. And I'm like, is Eric DaCosta being too much of a family guy, too much of a friend guy to these, to Ozzie, to Harbaugh? Because Harbaugh, I believe, like, for example, last year, Ojabo, everybody knows the Ravens needed a wide receiver. He just traded a wide receiver. You pick up Ojabo. Now, I was excited about that pick, but I thought they was going to get a wide receiver or kind of trade back in, but it didn't happen. Now, so many people wanted Pickens, which I agree. Pickens looks special. He looks like he got that dog. Like I think I said it before in another video. Pickens reminds me of an MP Juice Man, but on the offense. And if we just had that, that would be... But that's not the Ravens' way, because I believe Harbaugh changed that. There's no more dogs on the team like that, other than MP Juice Man. Really. I think Lamar got a little dog in him. But I don't know. I don't see him snapping on hard like that. Anyway. So, Eric DaCosta picked Ben Cleveland. That's a Harbaugh pick. Ojabo, Mike McDonald had a form in Yaya. That was like kind of his pick. And Harbaugh's pick, I believe, because his brother, you know. Once again, in my other video, I talked about that. Being Cleveland, Harbaugh pick. Let me see, who else? Man, it's a couple of Harbaugh picks. But you get the gist of it. And I'm like, the only way I feel that Eric DaCosta can redeem himself for as some of these questionable picks, I would say, is he got to show the Ravens flock, the Ravens fam. He got to show all of us some type of splash. Like, give away some picks, man. I don't remember the Ravens giving away a first round pick. If they did, somebody remind me. Put that in the comments. But I do not remember them giving away a first round pick ever to go and get somebody. Like a first round pick that is coming up in the next year or the year after, and they give away that. I don't remember that. I don't remember that ever happening. But I don't know how to judge Eric DaCosta, really. It's like Ozzie Newsome taught him everything he's done. That's the Ravens way, which is old now. And he's sticking with that method, but it's nothing promising. Back in the day, that might have been promising, but times change. And you would think Eric DaCosta being young, he could change with it, but I don't know. That's just the question about this whole front office, is what is that power? How much power does he have? I know Ozzie has power over all of them, except the owner, but I know Ozzie has power over all of them. Is Ozzie really making these picks and Eric DaCosta's getting dragged? Or Harbaugh says he don't want this pick? Like, I truly believe one of the main picks I know he made was PQ and Hollywood. But you see what happened with Hollywood. Like I said in my other video, Harv had a problem with Hollywood. Now he's gone. Does Harv have that much power over a general manager? It's just questions, so many questions after questions after questions of the Ravens front office. But yeah, so y'all tell me what's your grade. 10 being the highest. 0 being the lowest. Even if you want to go with alphabetical grading, my opinion, alphabetical grading, I give Eric DaCosta, I'm going with a C plus so far. The Hollywood pick, I loved it. Some of his late round picks, I like. You feel that question mark? I like, but it's this Ravens thing that they do, which I can't stand. They did it with Za'Darius Smith. They did it with Judon. They get these guys in the later round. They develop them 2-3 years. They play them on that. That last fourth year, they let them play, they ball out, then we lose them. And it's a rotation. It's a rotation of that. And it seems like that's what always happens. But anyway, so yeah, C plus. For his numbers, 6. Give him a 6 out of 10. 6 out of 10. I'm only saying 6 out of 10 because Hollywood is clowning in that Arizona, even though he got injured, but he's clowning out there in Arizona. So y'all tell me what you think. Just a discussion. Really ain't no debate or nothing like that. Just seeing if anybody's on the same level as me or kind of confused like I am too. Like, who has the power? Who has the Thanos rings? But yeah, so everybody hit the like, hit the share, hit the subscribe if you're not already subscribed to me. I've been seeing some of y'all been showing me love. I love seeing them comments. But everybody stay safe. God bless.